From the Gonzo Today newsroom, this is Memos from the National Affairs Desk. Presented by Gonzo Today. www.gonzotoday.com. The weird have just turned pro.
Hello, all you bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, wonderful folks out there. Welcome to another titillating edition of Gonzo Today's Memos from the National Affairs Desk. I'm your host, Dr. Jafarius Higginson. Hey, let's take a look at the news. Thursday evening's debate among the top Republican presidential frontrunners was the most watched non-sporting event in cable television history. Nielsen Research revealed on Friday about 24 million people watched the Fox News event, which was the first debate among the Republican knuckle-draggers. An earlier debate between the rest of the GOP field garnered about 6 million viewers. So many Republicans are running this time around that some hopefuls are being billed as the opening act for the swine who are basically headlining the debate. The Wall Street Journal reported that Thursday's debate easily outdrew Fox's previous record of 11.8 million viewers during a debate from the 2012 race. The event, however, was not enough to top January's college football championship between Oregon and Ohio State, which drew an audience of nearly 33.5 million people, which just goes to show you that when faced with matters that outline our collective impending doom, most folks would rather just go out to the game. Kind of brings a new tinge to the term running out the clock, huh? Perhaps one of the biggest factors in Thursday's viewership was the participation of the outspoken Donald Trump, who, as we expected, delivered numerous pokes and jabs and barbs during the entire debate. Trump later said of his blunt manner of speaking, "What I say is what I say. Part of the problem this country has is being politically correct. I don't have time for total political correctness." The debate also became known for one jab Trump made about a particular former daytime talk show host. Fox News personality and moderator Megyn Kelly said, "Mr. Trump, one of the things people love about you is that you speak your mind and you don't use a politician's filter. However, that is not without its downsides, in particular when it comes to women. You've called women you don't like fat pigs, dogs, slobs, and disgusting animals." To which Trump replied, "Only Rosie O'Donnell." Rosie O'Donnell responded immediately via Twitter, and she posted, "Try explaining that to your kids." So the next GOP debate is scheduled for September 16th. So you've got plenty of time to mark that on your calendars. Run out and get some vomit bags, and maybe some popcorn. The first Democratic debate will take place on October 13th. Both of those will be hosted and broadcast by CNN. A former Public Works employee in a North Carolina town said the acting town manager took a photo of his partially exposed ass and then showed it to colleagues. Johnny King, a former Public Works supervisor for the town of Chadburn, said acting town manager Patricia Gurrell took a photo of the partially exposed ass in question while he was repairing a water leak, and she showed the photo of his ass crack to the whole department the next day. What? King said his complaints about Gurrell and the photo led town officials to hold a series of closed session meetings on the subject, but no actions were taken. He said officials penalized him for complaining with measures including revoking his privilege to a take-home Public Works vehicle and adding him to the weekend on-call list. King said he was fired April 8th of this year, and the termination referenced a visit he made to the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission in Raleigh, where he had filed a complaint against the town alleging a hostile work environment and harassment. The town said King's visit to the EEOC was a violation of the sick leave policy. However, King's doctor, who wrote the initial note to get him sick leave for a few days in March for stress-related issues, later clarified that King was excused from work, but was not ordered to remain in bed during his time away from the department. King, who was denied unemployment benefits by the city, is appealing in court to receive unemployment. He also said he's planning to sue the town of Chadburn for wrongful termination. Chadburn town manager Robert C. Jones Jr., who took office in late March, said Gorrell snapped the photo and then showed it to colleagues to highlight workers' need for chest-high waders. Oh, so there you go. It was all for the benefit of the municipal workers. How could we have ever questioned the intentions of a seemingly uppity town manager lady, huh? How? You feeling that sarcasm? It should be getting you right there. Right there under the throat right about now. Right there. Huh? Mm-hmm.
Safety is everyone's business. We can all stay out of harm's way just by following a few simple rules. When you're out in public, always check to make sure no spies are following you. If you find a spider on your shirt, roll. Roll on the ground. Spiders are icky. And if you lose a pants leg, call home right away so your friends won't beat you up for looking like a dork. Don't let your parents drive backwards in the rain. It's just not safe. If Dad needs to take a nap, tell him to do it in a bed. That's what they're made for. And never, ever let your dog drive the car.
Authorities in Ohio said a fight in a prison yard was found to be spurred by a package of drugs dropped into the facility by a drone. The Ohio Department of Rehabilitation and Correction said the drone flew over the North Recreation Yard of the Mansfield Correction Institution on July 27th and then dropped a package containing 5 ounces of tobacco, 2.3 ounces of marijuana, and 0.23 ounces of heroin, believed to have been intended for an inmate. Let's hope it wasn't for the warden, but you never know in this day of age. Everybody likes to party, right? Huh? The package spurred a fight between 9 inmates. Oh, you bet it did. The fight was broken up with no injuries, and the fighters were placed in solitary confinement with no drugs. This all according to officials. The drugs were seized by correction officers. See, I'm not implying anything here. Corrections spokeswoman Joellen Smith said officials have previously had run-ins with drones, but she did not give any details of the incidents. Smith told the Columbus Dispatch that the agency's top security administrators are taking a broad approach to increase awareness and detection of unmanned aerial systems. The story surfaced among rumors of a similar incident at a prison in southern Illinois. Allegedly, another unmanned drone dropped packages of paper porn magazines into the recreation yard of the sexually criminals wing of the Illinois State Gropers Prison, located near Dix, Illinois. And finally in the news, for those of you who are really big fans of meth lab news, get ready to scratch your open sores and grind your teeth because police in Cedar Rapids, Iowa said a Taco Bell worker and another man were arrested after officers found meth lab remnants inside the fast food restaurant. Cedar Rapids Public Safety spokesman Greg Bulow said officers responded on Tuesday to a report of suspicious persons at Taco Bell. This is after it was closed, of course. And officers arrived to find 2 adult men outside the restaurant. One of the men told police that he was an employee at the eatery, Bulow said. Officers went inside the restaurant at the request of a manager, and the investigators found materials identified as equipment for the production of methamphetamine. The men were taken to a police station to be interviewed while officers in hazardous material suits investigated at Taco Bell. Police did not say on Tuesday whether it appeared meth had been cooked inside Taco Bell, but you never know, right? Whoa. Well, that does it for this week's edition of Gonzo Today's Memos from the National Affairs Desk. I'm your host, Dr. Furious Higgison. I hope you had a good time. I certainly did over here. Look us up on the web at gonzotoday.com. We're on Facebook and Twitter. Also, make sure that you check out the new Gonzoville Tonight program, which you can usually find over at gonzotoday.com. Or you can just, you know, it pops up on the Facebook whenever we get it done. So be on the lookout for that, because that's a really fun show. Gonzo Today and Memos from the National Affairs Desk, copyright 2015. I'm going to slap this one on for you right now and leave it with you. Thanks a lot. See you next week.
Well, I'm Ever Upper Class High Society. Got the gift of ballroom notoriety. And I always feel my balls, if that's no small. Social pages say I got the biggest balls of all. I got big balls, yeah, I got big balls. And such big balls and dirty big balls. And he's got big balls and she's got big balls. We got the biggest balls of all. The balls are always bouncing, the balls are always full. And everybody comes and comes again. If your name is on the guest list, no one can take you higher. Everybody says I got great balls of fire. I got big balls, oh, I got big balls. They're such big balls, dirty big balls. He's got big balls, and she's got big balls. We got the biggest balls of them all. Some balls are held for charity and some for fancy dress. When they're held for pleasure, they're the balls I like best. My balls are always bouncing to the left and to the right. And it's my belief that my big balls should be held every night. I got big balls, oh, I got big balls. They're such big balls, and dirty big balls. He's got big balls, she's got big balls. We got the biggest balls of all. How you know I'm just itching to tell y'all about them. How we have such a wonderful fun. Seafood cocktail, crab, cow daddy. Yeah, we got big balls. Everybody twist. No, 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 not the ball. Partner doing bros, been around that, that was it, no. It's a